If you're paying attention at this minute, you can absolutely snag cars. When like good sellable, you know, not even necessarily smudged up cars, something that ain't got a big Carfax and don't have too many miles, and it is got a decent amount of equipment. Those cars, and they're generally in the middle of the bell curve. There's plenty of them, and they're all around, and they can get them and see them in different places and so forth. Those cars are falling way under whatever they've been selling for on a regular basis. So my feeling is, and of course we do this 1,000 times a week, so we really do understand that regardless of what you're setting them in, there's less in interest and less activity. Therefore, the opportunity to pinch them cars is way higher than it was before. And I would only suggest we will never, ever think that we know something that we can talk like the professor and tell somebody else what they should or shouldn't do. Last thing on earth I'll ever do, right? But when you do watch a rocket shot, make sure you're also watching cars that are around it that aren't the ultimate unbelievable tits up car, you follow me, that the next one is, because the difference between the ultimate unbelievable, this is the only one in the world, best of all cars, and one notch below that is a world of difference in valuation. It's all about when you got the best one, you can't even talk about the one notch down and what that's worth, because everybody's focused on that car. That's the one, you know, in the olden days when you'd have a mob scene following a car into the room. You follow me? It's hoovering. It ain't even on its wheels. It's hoovering into the lane. You understand? And emotions are flying. Now you're not even talking about buying a car. You're talking about testosterone. You're talking about who's going to pay. Oh, he didn't buy. I'm buying it. He's not buying. I bought it. There's 63 people with their hands flying in the air. That's the car that on the, you know, in today's world of the marketplace, that's the car where some 50 people bid. But that's the one of 37. That's the one of 52 that actually do that. All the rest of them, you know, the real market. Can you duplicate that price is really the only way of knowing what's worth or not. Car brings a rocket shot. My question is this. Bring it in 13 cars later. Bring it in tomorrow. Can you duplicate that price? The probability of duplicating is just about zero.